Good day, my viewers. My name is Olapo Jibamdele. I'm the managing partner of PPS, a professional service firm located in Ikeja, out of Lagos, Nigeria. Today, I would like to talk to you about some of the changes that recently took place on Common Income Tax Act. So I would like to look at profit exempted from taxes. I call it part four of my presentation, profit exempted from taxes. Several sections were amended to have these changes. Examples are section 23, subsection 1, section 40, section 41, and section 43. So let's just briefly look at the implications of these amendments. Number one, profits of the following companies or entities not derived from trade are affected by the amendments. They are mosques, churches, educational, charity, cooperative society, etc. They must now charge withholding taxes at the point of payment of dividend, rent, or royalty, and remit accordingly. This is what it's saying. For those entities that are ordinarily exempted from Nigerian taxes under CETA, you know, especially they are part of operation that has to do with non-profit making. This is what it's saying. It's possible ordinarily church, mosque, charity, NGOs are tax exempted. But when under CETA now, but when they have a arm of the organization that is into trading, generating income, that portion is fully subjected to all Nigerian taxes. But this is where the change is coming in. Even for the non-profit making aspect of these organizations we have mentioned, like church, mosque, educational, you know, cooperative society, and all the rest, when they pay rent, they are meant to withhold taxes at the source and remit to government. So if you are a church and you rented a place as place of worship, before you pay your landlord or your landlady the annual rent, you are meant to withhold relevant withholding taxes at the source and remit back to government. The same goes for charity organizations, mosques, and what have you. Then the current impediment to creation of unit trust in Nigeria has been removed by exempting such companies from having to deduct withholding taxes on dividends they pay out. That's a good one, positive one there. Three, small companies must comply with all relevant tax registration and filing obligations in order to claim tax relief or common income tax exemption. Let me paraphrase that. You know, right now, according to these recent changes under CETA, companies in Nigeria are now subclassified into three categories: small, medium, and large, by threshold turnover. If you have 100 million, above 100 million, you are large. You have between 25 million to 100 million, you are medium. You have lesser than 25 million, then you are small. So when you are a small company, it means that you are not meant to pay taxes. You are not meant to pay company income tax. And it means that you are not meant to pay VAT, all right? But one thing that I've not seen from my review of all these changes is education tax. Education tax was not amended. Tax Act was not amended to say that if you're a small company, you will not pay education tax. So that will be subjected to a lot of debate and back and forth before tribunal or a court will step into it and help us interpret. But sir, as far as I'm concerned, education tax for small company has not been waived off. I've not seen that. So, but as far as CIT is concerned, yes. As far as VAT is concerned, yes. But we must understand that this act now put conditions that before a small company will even claim, you know, of claiming relief not to pay company income tax, you must have ensured, apart from the fact that you have not crossed the threshold of 25 million turnover, you must have ensured that all the required statutory really required filings have been done up to date, up to the time you are filing returns. If you miss any one of them, then you have automatically disqualified yourself from enjoying or claiming the reliefs of payment of no company income tax. That's what that is saying. Then, number four, small companies are not exempted from deduction of withholding taxes at the source and remittance of the same. So small companies should know that even though you are not meant to pay company income taxes, if you meet all the conditions, you are not meant to pay VAT and not charge VAT if you meet all the conditions, but you are not exempted from charging withholding taxes when you are making payment to third parties. You are meant to charge, withhold, and remit accordingly to the government, to the Federal Revenue Service or state tax authority, whichever applies in that case. So I believe that one of the conditions that tax office or FRS will be looking for when they want to grant relief, when they want to see whether a small company should take relief or not, is all the payments you have made, where are the withholding taxes, receipts, evidences that you have withheld and you have remitted. So please let us be aware. This is something that we have to take serious now. If you don't deduct and remit when you are making payment at a small company, you may not likely enjoy the relief of no tax, no income tax, no VAT when you file your returns. Investment tax credits eliminated by Section 40. This is what it means. In that section before now, if you are in a business and you have to help government construct road, especially if you are 20 kilometers away from the main expressway, you constructed road, you know, you put up the electric pole and infrastructure. You know, before there are certain provisions under that Section 40 that will give you tax relief. But right now, it's been taken out, eliminated. Now, before now, I mean, companies have not fully commenced. That is to say, they have not started earning, they've not started activities, and they've not started earning revenue before now. They don't pay taxes. What they need to do is to file, prepare out the testament of affairs, and pay a preparational levy of 20,000 in the first year, and in subsequent years, 25,000 per year, and obtain their tax clearance. But it's no more so, because from February 1st, 2020, provisional levy has been eliminated by the same Section 40. What's the implication for companies that have not commenced operation? The implication is very simple. Make sure you have registered for your VAT. You know, you have your TIN number. Prepare your audit testament of affairs, ask your auditors to prepare for you, and just file without payment of any provisional levy, then you are sure of getting your tax clearance. All right, that's a positive one right there. So this number seven is still talking about classifications of Nigerian companies into three: small, medium, and large. You are small if your turnover is less than 25 million. You are medium if it's between 25 to 100 million, and you are large if your turnover is more than 100 million. So for companies that are medium, small companies, they don't pay company income tax, they meet all the other conditions attached. Medium-sized companies, they are now to pay company income tax of 20% instead of the usual 30%. While large companies will pay do their corporate tax at the normal 30%. So medium-sized company, that's a positive one for you there. Thank you very much.